Welcome back. I'm Ashley Weiss, joined by Nike pole vaulter and Olympic hopeful, Sandy Morris. Sandy, there's more to you than what people see on the track. You're also quite the comedian. You started a YouTube series a few years back called Things People Say to Pole Vaulters. How did that get started?
Well, the pole vault community, we're all a little bit crazy. I mean, you have to be kind of goofy and crazy to want to fling yourself full speed at an inanimate object. Sorry, I got tongue-tied there, but I just have always kind of taken a passion to video, and my sophomore year of college, I discovered Jenna Marbles, and she was kind of somebody that I watched on YouTube a lot, and I was like, I feel like the pole vault community needs somebody to kind of put a video out there that describes the hilarious things that we experience behind the scenes, whether it's traveling with poles, which is always a huge hassle, or just getting the crazy, silly questions that we get as pole vaulters. So that kind of prompted it, and my friends really loved it, so I made a couple of them.
What's the silliest question anyone's ever asked you about pole vaulting?
I've been asked if they were skis when I was traveling with them, and I don't know what size they think skis are, but I guess they were the biggest skis in the world.
All right, let's get down to business here for a minute. You're in your first year running for Nike. How has that been so far?
Oh gosh, it's been an amazing journey. I mean, my last year of college here at Arkansas was phenomenal, breaking collegiate records. I won my first national title. And that kind of set me up to go into the professional world and be ready for the kind of competitions that I would be presented with. I got a chance to go overseas. I spent 8 weeks in Europe competing on the European circuit, went head to head with some of the best girls in the world. And now this past season, my first professional season, I ended up getting silver at the World Championships and winning my first US national title. So. Having that really competitive senior year in college really set me up to transition into a professional season that I would be ready for.
How has the training in college differed from the professional training that you've undergone?
Well, I'm still training here at the University of Arkansas with my coach, Coach Compton. I'm just listed as a volunteer coach as well so that I can use the facilities, work with the girls. And it's a really good situation because I'm here and it's a really great recruiting tool for the Arkansas team. But then at the same time, I get to train with the same girls that I've been training with and work with my coach and use the facilities. And yeah, it's just a really awesome situation. And the only difference really is the professional season is a bit delayed. So our competitions start a little bit later than the college girls do. So I would say the only thing that I struggle with is my coach cannot come to meets with me. Only a few of them he can come to. And so that's been very different for me because, you know, he's at home training with the college girls and I have to go off and perform without a coach being there with me.
How have you been able to adjust to that?
I'm just really lucky to have a really tight-knit support group. My parents are very supportive. My dad flew out to Portland a few weeks ago to be there for me at the USA National Championships, and he was actually my coach for the day. And my dad was a decathlete at Western Illinois back in college, so he did the pole vault, even though I've officially jumped higher than he did, and we have a good laugh about that. But you know, he was there to catch my step and to be there for me, and sometimes in a competition that's all you need is just somebody to kind of bounce ideas off of. You know, I've gotten to the point where I know what I'm doing in a meet, and really I just have to have somebody who can catch my step and for me to say out loud, I think I'm gonna move my standards in, I think I'll go to this different pole, what do you think? And he would just kind of verbally encourage me, and it really turned out awesome. I ended up jumping a huge PR and winning US Nationals, so I think it worked out well.
What was his reaction to jumping higher than he did?
It was really funny. He jumped 15 feet in college, and so a year ago when I jumped 15 feet for the first time, we just had a good laugh about it. And I know that my dad was a very talented athlete. He didn't have a pole vault coach, and I honestly think that if my dad did have a pole vault coach, he would have jumped 18.6 at the time, and that was back in the 70s. So I don't know. We just got a good kick out of it because. I mean, for him to be able to say that he has a daughter who has jumped higher than him in the pole vault, it's just a funny situation.
Since he's kind of been in the track world, how does he feel about you training for the Olympics?
Oh gosh, my parents joke about all the time how I must have gotten every single ounce of athletic ability from their genetics as possible. You know, they were phenomenal athletes, but you know, they never did it, got to the level where they could do it post-collegiately. So they could be nothing but proud, and my entire career they have supported me and taken me all over the country to get in the right hands of the right coaches, paid so much money out of pocket, and I know that I definitely would not be where I am today if it weren't for them and all of their sacrifices.
What is your ultimate goal professionally?
I want to have a long, healthy career. You know, pole vaulting is one of the sports that you can do into your early to mid 30s competitively. To put it into perspective, Jen Scher, she's an Olympic champion, world champion, and world record holder indoor, and she just broke her own indoor world record this season, and she, I believe, is 34 years old. So I think this will be her last go-around. She'll probably retire after this Olympic season, but you never know what Jen Scher is going to do. She's kind of unexpected when it comes to decisions she's made, and she's on fire right now. She's doing really well. So my goal as a pole vaulter is just to do what she's done, you know, stay healthy for 7 to 10 years, give myself 3 shots at an Olympic team and an Olympic medal, and just stay healthy and keep jumping high.
Okay, this is probably the most serious question I'm going to ask you, so be prepared. If you are away in Rio at the Olympics, who's going to take care of your 3 snakes?
Oh gosh, yeah. I've been a huge animal lover my entire life, and I've had to really cut down on the number of animals that I have just because I do travel for 4, 6, 8 weeks at a time once season really gets going. And I do have a boyfriend here in Fayetteville who has the lovely honor of taking care of my zoo when I leave for competitions. But reptiles, or snakes specifically, are really perfect for me because they really don't take that much care once, you know, you feed them once a week, once every 2 weeks, make sure they have water. They're pretty easygoing pets to have, so they're kind of the perfect animal for somebody who travels a lot.
Perfect fit.
Yeah.
All right, well, that is all the time we have for today. Thank you so much, Sandy.
Yes, thanks for having me.
We'll be right back.